Good morning and welcome to the Presbyterian Church of Waynesboro. We are happy that you are able to worship with us today as we celebrate this special day in the life of our congregation and in the life of the world as we celebrate Mother's Day. And we thank all the mothers in our congregation and all of the mothers who are friends of our congregation wherever they are throughout the world. And if you will you pray with me, please? Thank you, Lord, that you fill a mother's heart with love, that you have instilled in her very being the need to protect her children if at all possible. Thank you for giving her the gift of nurturing her children, of teaching them, of comforting them, for feeding them and making a safe place for them, for guiding them to be all that God has created them to be. For fill every mother with love, wisdom, and endurance, with strength and patience and joy. Give them ability to forgive again and again. Enable her to rely on you and call upon you, because you will give her all she needs. In your precious and all-powerful name we pray. Amen. That heals and listens. Open wounded hearts to the balm of your word. Speak to us in clear tones so that we might feel our spirits leap for joy and skip with hope as your resurrection witnesses. Amen. The scripture is from Luke chapter 24, verses 13 through 35. That very day, two of them were going to the village named Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem, and talking with each other about all things that had happened. While they were talking and discussing together, Jesus himself drew near and went with them. But their eyes were kept from recognizing him, and he said to them, "What is this conversation which you are holding with each other as you walk?" And they stood still, looking sad. Then one of them, named Cleopas, answered him, "Are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who does not know the things that have happened there in these days?" And he said to them, "What things?" And they said to him, "Concerning Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet, mighty indeed, and word before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and rulers delivered him up to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one to redeem Israel. Yes, and besides all this, it is now the third day since this happened. Moreover, some women of our company amazed us. They were at the tomb early in the morning and did not find his body, and they came back saying that they had even seen a vision of angels who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but him they did not see. And he said to them, O foolish men, and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory? And beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them in all the scriptures and things concerning himself. So they drew near to the village to which they were going. He appeared to be going further, but they constrained him, saying, Stay with us, for it is toward evening, and the day is now far spent. So he went in to stay with them. When he was at table with them, he took the bread and blessed and broke it and gave it to them. And their eyes were opened and they recognized him, and he vanished out of their sight. They said to each other, Did not our hearts burn within us while he talked to us on the road, while he opened us to the scriptures? And they rose that same hour and returned to Jerusalem. And they found the 11 gathered together, and those who were with them, who said, The Lord has risen indeed, and has appeared to Simon. Then they told what had happened on the road, and how he was known to them in the breaking of the bread. Here ends the scripture.
Good morning, friends. The Presbyterian Church of Waynesboro is blessed to be part of the Carlisle Presbytery. Recently, we received a video from the Reverend Cheryl Galen, the interim executive presbyter, and she asked that it be made available to our congregations on a Sunday convenient for us. We have chosen Mother's Day to be able to hear her preach. We pray that her words will be a blessing to you, as she is a blessing to all of us. You will need to move from this video to the video displaying her words. Thank you.